So here I have the same transformation. Well, that's not the same, but I have the same two things going on, the absolute value and a left 3. Okay, now it's going to be in different order now. We also have this negative on the outside that we're not going to be too worried about because we just deal with that as we go. More importantly, we want to deal with this absolute value. Now this is going to be the opposite. We're going to mirror first and then left 3. So we can see that when we undo the notation. So again, remember this is my notation. This represents notation. Okay, so then I need to undo this notation. So I solve this absolute value. So we'll get plus minus first, and then I do minus 3 last. So this is my description or my do part. This is what I'm going to do. Okay, so when I do this, I'm going to do the plus minus first. We get rid of the negative, mirror the positive first, and then we shift 3. Okay, this is actually the easier version because when we're going to do the mirroring right away, and that's we don't have to worry about that center point moving around. So here we're going to do our mirroring first. So we're going to do the plus minus first, so it looks like this. Get rid of the negatives and mirror the positives. So we're going to end up with negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Okay, so all these coordinates now disappear. So this is my original graph. Let's just sketch in my original graph again. It's got my parabola here. It's the same as the last example. Okay, so we have our parabola. So the first thing that happened to this one is we got rid of the negative. So we're going to get rid of this, and then now we're going to mirror it. Okay, so we've mirrored the po negative onto the positive. So all these positive points get mirrored around here. Okay, so that's what it looks like. It's going to look like that. Okay, so I'm just going to get rid of that. Okay, so then I've done the mirroring part of it. Now the last step was just to apply my transformation of shifting. So I'm just going to do all my x's at once, and then I'm going to do my y's afterwards. So my x's get shifted. What was it again? Left 3. Left 3. So I'm going to take every coordinate and shift them left 3. So 0, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. Okay, that's all my x transformations now. I've done my mirroring, get rid of the negative, mirror the positive onto the negative side. I've done my left 3. Now I've just got to make sure I do my y transformation, which is flipping it upside down. So it's going to go flip all my y coordinates upside down, and I get this. So I should end up with this kind of McDonald's M shape upside down. Okay, well, actually, it's a W and then becomes a McDonald's M shape. So, plotting these coordinates then, I'm just going to plot the negative 6, so 3, 6, negative 1, 5, 0, negative 4, 1, negative 3, negative 4. Okay, now that happens to be my mirror point. Okay, so I want to keep track of that. That's my mirror point. So my symmetry is going to be through that line right there. Okay, and then graph the other coordinates, negative 2, negative 1, negative 1, 0. It's going to look like that. So my graph then is going to be this shaped graph. Okay, so there it is. There's my mirroring, my getting rid of the negative. So I chopped off this parabola, that part of the parabola got chopped off when I did the absolute value, the plus minus part. Got chopped off right there. I mirrored the negative onto the sorry the positive onto the negative. Then I did my shift, and I did my flip in this case.